This is part 6 of a series on attention networks. In this video, we will write code to predict a time series using a transformer model. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice is generated by AI, text-to-speech. In the last two chapters, we predicted time series using sequence-to-sequence-based models. In this video, we will predict time series using a transformer model that only uses attention, rather than a sequence model. Instead of writing our own transformer code from scratch, we'll use the code posted on this site. Since this code is for natural language processing, it needs some modifications to be used for time series forecasting. Let's modify the decoder class first. Remove the input argument vocab size. This is the vocabulary size used in the word embedding layer. And remove the word embedding as well. Instead, we use the time series embeddings outside this class. We don't need this since we will be using time series data. And modify the multiply constant class as follows. In the last video, instead of not using a sequence model, we added positional encodings to the time series embedding vector. We mentioned that the original time series may be affected when the elements of the embedding vector are small or the position encodings are large. To reduce this effect, we multiply the embedding vector by a constant value. Section 3.4 of the paper mentions multiplying by the square root of D model. But this code multiplies by D model. Modify this to multiply by the square root of D model. Next, we modify the encoder class. As with the decoder, we remove the vocab size argument and the word embedding. And modify the multiply constant class. Next, we will modify the padding mask class as follows. Before discussing padding masks in time series analysis, let's first briefly review the role of padding masks in natural language processing. In natural language processing, padding tokens are added to keep the length of a data sequence constant. For example, if we have a sentence like this, let's say we represent it as a vector with 5 elements, as follows. These numbers are token IDs. And these are padding token IDs, zeros. When computing attention values, attention is required between these tokens, but no attention is required between these tokens and the padding tokens. For this, we create a padding mask vector like this. This step in the original code produces the padding mask vector. If the input is not zero, it is marked as zero, otherwise it is marked as one. And in the multi-head attention process that we looked at in the last video, we add the values in the padding mask multiplied by negative infinity to the scaled dot product result. This calculation is done by broadcasting. Applying softmax to this result gives us the following results. Here, the columns are the key side, and the rows are the query side. You can see that only the pads on the key side are masked. There is no need to mask the queries. We'll look at this in more detail later in the natural language processing tutorial. The attention weights between this token and the pad tokens are zeros. You can get the attention value by multiplying the attention weights by the value. This is the masking process shown in this figure. This class returns a four-dimensional padding mask. The first dimension is the batch size of the inputs. The second dimension is the number of heads. The third dimension is the length of the token sequence on the query side. And the fourth dimension is the length of the token sequence on the key side. Addition of this with a scaled dot product is done by broadcasting. Now let's look at the padding mask for time series prediction. In fact, padding masks are not necessary for time series forecasting. Time series data does not require padding because the length of the sequence is constant. This class is used multiple times in other classes in this source code file, so removing it would require a lot of modifications. So we use this class, but we set all the elements of the padding mask to zeros. This eliminates the need to modify other classes. If all elements of a padding mask are zero, it is equivalent to not applying the mask. In natural language processing, inputs are two-dimensional, a none by the sequence length matrix. But our inputs for the time series are three-dimensional, none, comma, the sequence length, comma, D model. You can see this later in the code that calls this class. Next, we will modify the padding and look-ahead mask class as follows. In the absence of padding, the look-ahead mask used for mask multi-head attention in the decoder can be simply generated as follows. We'll look at the case with padding later in the natural language processing tutorial. This is exactly the same as what we saw in the last video. Look-ahead mask is also four-dimensional. The second dimension is the number of heads. The third and fourth are the sequence lengths. Now let's write a code to predict a time series using a transformer model. First, we write the code for the training stage, teacher forcing. Import the encoder and decoder classes from the transformer code we just modified. We also import the padding mask and padding and look-ahead mask classes. Read a time series dataset. This is the dataset used in the seek-to-seek attention model in the previous video. The number of time steps, i.e. the length of the sequence, is 50. The number of features is 2. For more information about time series dataset, please watch the first video in this series. D model is set to 100. Next, we build an encoder model. Instantiate a time series embedding layer to be used in the encoder and decoder. The number of output neurons is D model. This is a simple feedforward network like this. Create an input layer for the encoder. The input data is three-dimensional. Then create an embedding layer. When time series data is input to this layer, embedding vectors are output. The parameter of this layer is a 2x100 matrix. And the output of this layer is a none, 50, 100 tensor. None is the batch size of the data. 50 is the sequence length of the data, and 100 is D model. Next, create a padding mask layer. Embedding vectors are fed into this layer. Padding mask is not required for time series forecasting, but we used it to minimize modifications to the transformer code. As explained earlier, this layer produces a tensor like this one, with all elements being zero. Next, create an encoder layer. The number of layers is set to 1. The number of heads to be used for multi-head attention is set to 5. And the number of hidden neurons to be used in position-wise feed-forward networks is set to 64. The embedding vector h-enc and the padding mask are fed into the encoder. Next, we create a decoder model. We create an input layer and an embedding layer. Next, we create a padding and look-ahead mask layer and feed the embedding vector HDC into that layer. This is used in the masked multi-head attention module of the decoder, as seen in the previous page. And we create a decoder layer. Set the input arguments of the decoder to be the same as those of the encoder. Finally, create an output layer and feed the output of the decoder, ODC, into that layer. Create an encoder-decoder model and compile it. We use mean squared error loss instead of softmax. Fit this model to the training data and save the training parameters to this file. This is the training stage, teacher forcing. Let's run this code. While previous seek-to-seek attention model computes attention values time step by time step, transformer computes all attention values at once, making it faster. The training is complete. The train parameters of this model are stored in this file. Next, let's write a code to predict a time series using the trained model. Read the saved data set. We only read the entire time series data. The prediction process does not require training data. We want to predict future time series that will appear after the entire time series. Create an encoder and a decoder and build a model just like the training code on the previous page. The second dimension in the input layer of the decoder is set to none to receive sequences of arbitrary length. The parameters of this model are independent of the sequence length, so they are identical to the trained model. And then we read the trained parameters and load them into this model. Predict future values for the next 50 periods. The data to be fed into the encoder are the last 50 data points of the time series. The initial data to be fed into the decoder is structured in this way. The first one is set to the last data point of the time series, and the rest are unknown, so they are all set to 0. Feed the E data and D data into the encoder-decoder model. Then the next predicted value will be output. Initially, only Y1 is a reasonably predicted value. Then we add Y1 to the decoder input like this. Then next time, both Y1 and Y2 will be reasonably predicted values. We also add Y2 to the decoder input for the next iteration like this. Repeating this process 50 times will give you the predictions for the next 50 periods. Finally, let's plot the last 100 data points of our time series and the 50 predicted future values. The past time series and the predicted future time series are as follows. The blue and red are the observed past time series. The green and orange are the predicted future time series. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. So far, we have looked at all the attention networks through 6 videos.